This is really quite surprising to me actually, but one of the most requested things people contact me about is how I created all of the simulated power sensors in Home Assistant that I used to demonstrate the various power flow cards in a number of videos I made last year. Well, it's actually really quite simple, so I thought I'd put together this little tutorial to show you exactly how I did it. So this is a multi-step process. First, we need to create a bunch of number helpers. These will be our controls. We can add them to our dashboard and move the sliders to adjust how much power we want to simulate for a given item. Those items might be your grid power, your solar power, your car charger, that sort of thing. The problem with number helpers, though, is that they're not power sensors. So even if you tell Home Assistant that the unit of measurement is watts, it won't behave like a power sensor. So we have to then wrap the number helper in a template sensor. Let's dive into Home Assistant and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So we start by navigating down to Settings, across to Devices and Services, and over to Helpers, which is up in the top right. We click on Create Helper and we want to create a number helper here. Now I'm going to call this first one Sim Power Grid. And this is going to be a grid power sensor, and I'm going to pretend that we can export 8000, so the minimum value needs to be -8000, and that's in watts, and the maximum value 8000. Now you can obviously adjust that for your own personal taste. Oh, it's jumped down as I scrolled. Display mode must be set to slider, step size of 1, and unit of measurement is capital W for watts. Very important, it's capital W. And we click on create. Now, notice here it says entity ID. So make a note of that entity ID, which is sim_power_grid, because you're gonna need that in the next step. So we're gonna create another helper. And this time we're going to create a template helper, and you've got two options, a binary sensor or a normal sensor. We're just going to choose a normal sensor. Okay, so we're going to give this the exact same name, Sim Power Grid, and the state template, I'm going to paste this in, is basically saying take the value from the input number Sim Power Grid entity that we created previously. So that's why you need to make sure you made a note of the entity ID of the helper that you created previously, because you're going to need to make sure it matches this one here. Now the unit of measurement is again capital W for watts. Device class, we're going to scroll down and find power in this list. State class is measurement, because it's a point in time measurement. Watts can change as time goes by, as opposed to a total or a total increasing, which would be something like energy that would increase throughout the day. So this one is measurement. So we click on submit and finish. Let's head on over to the dashboard then and edit the dashboard. I'm going to add a card of type entities. I'm going to get rid of the default ones there, and I'm going to add in Sim Power Grid, the input number, and Sim Power Grid, the sensor, and click on save and done. Now, hopefully you should be able to tweak this slider here and see the sensor value for Sim Power Grid underneath also changing at the same time. They should basically both be exactly the same number if you've done this right. So now you can repeat that same process for other simulated power entities that you might want to create. You just need to make sure that you set the maximum and minimum values of the number helper to sensible limits. So for example, a car charger usually can't go above 7,500 watts or below 0 watts, but a battery can import and export, so it can be both positive and negative. I'm going to go ahead and create some more simulated power entities, so I'll see you in a minute. Okay, so now we have all of these simulated power sensors, we can start to use them to test out things like power flow cards, such as the Power Flow Card Plus. So just as a bit of a demonstration, I'm going to show you using these simulated power sensors in the Power Flow Card Plus, which I'm going to assume you've already got installed through hacks. I'm going to edit my dashboard, add a card, and the card is going to be Power Flow Card Plus. Right, I go to grid, we've got a combined entity, so I'm going to use the entity of sim power grid, and we want the sensor, not the input number. And I'm going to go back, we add one for the solar as well, and it's sim power solar, again the sensor, not the input number. And then for the battery, again it's a combined entity, so we want sim power battery. That should do for the moment. I'm going to save that and done. So you can see we've got this nice little power flow diagram on the right hand side here, and if I tweak this value here, you should see we get more solar being generated. We're at 1.8, we're at 2.5 now, and you can see the more that I increase this, the more that the home value is also showing it's using. But let's say we want to pretend that the battery is actually charging from some of that. So now 1.2 kilowatts of it is going into the battery, 447 watts is going out to the grid. But we can actually tweak the grid and we can say we're exporting a little bit more. So now the home, well, it's a bit too much, but there we go. Because the home should never really be zero in reality. But these are only simulated sensors just for playing around a bit. So this method isn't just limited to power sensors. You can simulate all sorts of numeric sensors this way, like battery charge percentages, temperature sensors, air quality, light levels, basically anything listed in the device class dropdown of the template sensor helper. I use simulated sensors to test automations for all sorts of things in a controlled way without needing to wait for real sensors to give me the required values. If I'm writing an automation that will only run when it's dark, I can test it during the day by feeding it a simulated sensor that I can control. Anyway, I hope you found this useful. If you did, then please give the video a like, and I'll put a link to my website in the description where you can find the template code I used in this demo. These people here are my channel members, and I want to say thank you to them as always for their support. If you'd like to become a channel member too and get early access to my videos, then please check out the link in the description or click on the join button under the video for more information. Don't forget to make sure that you subscribe to my channel for free too. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.